Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I welcome to video 11 and it is based on heteroscedasticity. Let me start with the multiple regression model of this form, where y is equal to beta naught plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 up to beta k xk plus u, where u is the error term. Let me start with the assumption of homoscedasticity that is used in classical linear regression model, which implied that condition on the explanate variables x is the variance of the unobserved error, that is u, was constant. If this is not true, that is, if the variance of u is not constant but it varies from various values of the x variables, then the errors are heteroscedastic, and examples of heteroscedastic error includes estimating returns to education and ability is unobservable, and think the variance in ability differs by educational attainment. This is the example of heteroscedasticity. As the value of x increases, so does the value of variance. So if you look at this diagram, along the vertical axis, as x varies from x1 up to x3, the variance increases. That is, the expected value of y given x is equal to beta naught plus beta 1 x. But if you look at the variance increases. Why should we be worried about the heteroscedasticity? OLS is still unbiased and consistent even if we do not assume homoscedasticity. The standard errors of the estimates are biased if we have heteroscedasticity. If the standard errors are biased, we cannot use the usual t-test or f-statistic or Lagrange multiplier statistic for drawing inferences. Variance with heteroscedasticity. If the variance of the error term is heteroscedastic, then in that case beta 1 hat is equal to beta 1 plus summation xi minus x bar times ui divided by summation xi minus x bar square. So variance of beta 1 hat is equal to summation xi minus x bar square sigma I square divided by total sum of square, where SST is equal to summation xi minus x bar square. A valid estimator for this when sigma I square is not equal to sigma is summation xi minus x bar square ui hat square divided by total sum of square, where ui hat are the OLS residuals. For the general multiple regression model, a valid estimator of the variance beta j hat with heteroscedasticity is variance of beta j hat, which is equal to summation rij hat ui hat square divided by total sum of square, where r I j hat is the ith residual from regressing x j and all other independent variables, and s s t j is the sum of squared residuals from this regression. Now that we have a consistent estimate of the variance, the square root can be used as a standard error for inference. Typically call these robust standard errors. Sometimes the estimated variance is corrected for degrees of freedom by multiplying by n divided by n minus k minus 1. As n increases, it is all the same though. Important to remember that these robust standard errors only have asymptotic justification with small sample sizes. T statistics formed with the robust standard errors will not have a distribution close to the t, and inferences will not be correct. In strata, robust standard errors are highly easily obtained using the robust options of REG, that is regression. A robust LM statistic. For this purpose, we will run OLS on the restricted model and save the residual u hat and regress each of the excluded variables on all of the included variables, q different regressions, and save each set of residual r1, r2 up to rq, and regress a variable defined to be equal to 1 on r1, u, r2 hat, u hat, up to rq hat, u hat, with no intercept. The LM statistic is n minus SSR1, where SSR1 is the sum of squared residuals from this final regression. Testing for heteroscedasticity. Essentially, we may want to test H0, variance of ui given x1 up to xk is equal to sigma square, which is equivalent to H0 expected value of u square given x1, x2 up to xk is equal to expected value of u square is equal to sigma square. If assumed the relationship between u2 and xj will be linear, we can test as a linear restriction. So far, u square is equal to sigma naught plus sigma 1 x1 up to sigma k xk plus v. This means that testing h0 sigma 1 is equal to sigma 2 up to sigma k is equal to 0. The Brush-Pagan test. We do not observe the error but can estimate it with the residual from the OLS regression. After regressing the residuals squared on all of the x variables, can use the R square to form an F or LM test. The F statistic is just the reported F statistic for overall significance of the regression, which is distributed with Fk and n minus k minus 1 degrees of freedom. The LM statistic is LM, that is equal to n R square, which is distributed, which has a chi square distribution with k degrees of freedom. Another test for detecting heteroscedasticity is the Voigt test. The Brush-Pagan test will detect any linear forms of heteroscedasticity. The Voigt test allows for non-linearities by using squares and cross products of all the x variables. Still, just using an F or LM test, whether all of the x variables and xj square and xj times xh are jointly significant, this can get to be unwieldy pretty quickly. Alternate form of the Voigt test. Consider that the fitted values of the OLS y hat are a function of all the x's. Thus, y hat square will be a function of the squares of the cross products, and y hat and y hat square can proxy for all of the xj, xj square and xj, xh. So, regress the residuals squared on y hat and y hat square and use the R square to form an FR LM statistic. Note only testing for two restrictions now. Weighted least squares. While it is always possible to estimate robust standard errors for OLS estimates, if we know something about the specific form of the heteroscedasticity, we can obtain more efficient estimates than OLS. The basic idea is going to be transform the model into one that has homoscedastic errors, and we call it weighted least square. Case of form being known up to a multiplicative constant. Suppose the heteroscedasticity can be modeled as variance of u given x is equal to sigma square h of x, where the trick is to figure out what h of x is identical to hi looks like. Expected value of ui given h divided by x under root is equal to 0, because hi is only a function of x, and variance of ui given hi divided by given x under root is equal to sigma square, because we know variance of u given x is equal to sigma square hi. So if you divide our whole equation by hi under root, you would have a model where the error is homoscedastic. Generalized least squares. Estimating the transformed equation by OLS is an example of the generalized least squares, that is GLS. GLS will be blue in this case. It is a weighted least squares WALS procedure, where each squared residual is weighted by the inverse of the variance of ui given xi. While it is intuitive to see why performing OLS on a transformed equation is appropriate, it can be tedious to do the transformation. Weighted least squares is a way of getting the same thing without the transformation. And the idea is to minimize the weighted sum of squares weighted by 1 divided by hi. More on WLS. A weighted least square is great if we know what variance of ui given xi looks like. In most cases, we won't know the form of the heteroscedasticity. Example where do if is if data is aggregated but model is individual level. We want to weight each aggregate observation by the inverse of the number of individuals. There is another method that is known as feasible GLS. More typical is the case where you don't know the form of the heteroscedasticity. In this case, you need to estimate h of xi. Typically, we start with the assumption of fairly flexible model such as variance of u given x is equal to sigma square, expected value of sigma naught plus sigma 1 x1 up to sigma k xk. Since we do not know the sigma, we must estimate. And our assumption implies that u square is equal to sigma square, expected value of sigma naught plus sigma 1 x1 plus up to plus sigma k xk times v, where v is the standard error, where expected value of v given x is equal to 1, even if expected value of ev is equal to 1. So, taking natural log of u square is equal to alpha naught plus sigma 1 x1 plus up to sigma k xk plus e, where expected value of e is equal to 1 and e is independent of x. Now we know that u hat is an estimate of u, so we can estimate this by OLS. Now an estimate of h is obtained by h naught, that is equal to expected value of g hat, and the inverse of this is our weight. So what did we do? Run the original OLS model, save the residual u hat, square them and take the log, regress natural log of u hat square on all of the independent variables and get the fitted values g hat. And do weighted least square using 1 divided by expected value of g hat as the weight. Wrapping up the WLS, when doing F test with the weighted least square, form the weights from the unrestricted model and use those weights to do weighted least square on the restricted model as well as the unrestricted model. Remember, we are using weighted least square just for efficiency because OLS is still unbiased and consistent, but we are using WLS for efficiency because the variance in this case will be minimum. Estimates will still be different due to sampling error, but if they are very different, then it is likely that some other Gauss Markov assumption is false. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a very brief but very informative video about heteroscedasticity and the issues related with it. I hope it was of help to you. You may like to share this video with your friends, with your colleagues, and if you haven't yet subscribed to the channel, kindly do subscribe, and you should not forget to click on the bell icon so that you can get timely notification about my other fabulous videos that I will upload for you very soon. I thank you very much for watching this video. Have a good afternoon.